Well, you know, we all, I think, can agree that we're at a crossroads of the country. And for us who have conservative values, we know that we need to support conservatives. And this man right here, as deputy majority leader for the Florida House of Representatives, was selected by Marco Rubio to become the House Majority Leader, so we can be sure that we've got a conservative here in Adam Hasner. I've made it publicly publicly known, I'm not a Mike Haradopoulos fan. I'm just making that clear. Now, that may rub some Republicans the wrong way, but I also agree that we need to get Bill Nelson out. And that's the most important thing. This is a man that could likely do it, so let's hear from him.
Thank you very much. Good morning. It is great to be on Main Street in downtown Sarasota. So we've been traveling the state, and I just have to tell you, I know it's a little bit warm, I know there's some bugs, but when things happen on the campaign, things happen for a reason. And I will tell you, the last few months of my life have been truly amazing, as I have been able to travel around the state and meet so many great people from around the state of Florida who share the view that I have, that now is a battle for the heart and soul of our country, and now is the time to fight. And that's why I'm running for United States Senate, because this is one of those moments in our nation's history that I think we're going to look back on 5 years, 10 years, 25 years from now and say, did we rise to the generational challenge to address the issues that are confronting us, to address the issues that are risking our freedoms and risking America's standing on the global stage? Did we rise to that challenge and be able to pass along to future generations the America that we inherited from our families, and more importantly, the America that provides the opportunity, that provides the American dream for so many of us? And so it's great to be with you this morning. It's great to see Chairman of the Republican Party of Sarasota County, Joe Greer. Thank you. I have to tell you, yesterday we were in Tampa and Pinellas County, and last night we were on our way to one of our evening events where we were going to speak to a group of energetic and excited patriots who are ready to fight to take our country back in the right direction. And for the first time during our campaign, our car broke down, and we were stranded about 20 minutes away from the event. Fortunately, we worked out a lot of the details. I got to the event and was able to meet the folks, and we got back. We rented a car. We're down here this morning, but we got in late last night. When we got to the hotel at the Hampton Inn over by the airport, the gentleman who checked us in, very, very nice man, we got to talk for a few minutes. It was about 12:30, almost 1 o'clock by the time we got there last night. So I told him when we checked in that we were probably going to be checking out before he was even off the night shift. And the reason why I tell you this story is we met him on the way out this morning. And his name's Joe Green. And Joe Green is not mean Joe Green, but Joe Green was a black gentleman who, as I was walking out of the building, told me, he said, "Are you one of those politicians that wants to take our country back?" And I explained to him, and I said, "Well, sir," I said, "I'm a conservative. I believe in limited government principles." And he said, "Well, tell me a little bit more about yourself." I said, "What I've seen in this country is that we've seen a deterioration and a breakdown in the family, that we have seen a distancing ourselves from the moral values that make our country special and great, those traditional Judeo-Christian principles that make our country great, that make our country special. And that breakdown, that deterioration has led to the growth in the size and scope of government, because people have become more dependent and more reliant on government. And as that's happened, we've seen spending grow out of control, we've seen taxes grow out of control, and government has continued to grow, and government has continued to creep into every crevice of our lives, personal, business, risking our own freedoms. And as we've continued to grow and continue to expand the size and scope of government, what we've seen is that we've now run up a debt of nearly $14.4 trillion. And that national debt is now our nation's greatest national security threat. And so as I'm explaining this to Joe, he started to tell me he's an independent voter. Joe says to me, I'm an independent voter. I don't just vote for Democrats, I vote for Republicans. And I told him, I said, listen, I understand where you're coming from. Because the problems we face in our country today weren't just created by the Democrats. Republicans share in the blame for where we are now as a country. And what's worse is that we've watched this happen year after year for the last few decades, and now we're at one of those points where we have really difficult decisions to make. And so last night as I was watching the TV when we got into the hotel, I wasn't sure what to think. Mitch McConnell came out with a plan to kind of do some type of backdoor end run around Obama. It seemed to me to be a lot more gamesmanship than it did leadership. Then what we need to do right now, I believe, is draw a line in the sand and say, this is what we stand for. Republicans need to be on offense. We need to be more aggressive. We need to say, this is what we stand for. And I'm not sure that we've been able to articulate that. And that's why this election is so important. And so I'm running for United States Senate. Many of you may know that I served in the state legislature. I know it was mentioned I was the majority leader of the Florida House. I'm from Palm Beach County, where I can tell you that it is not nearly as hospitable to be a conservative Republican as it is here in Sarasota County. So, Joe, you do a great job. But being a pro-life, pro-Second Amendment conservative from a district in Boca Raton, Florida, that voted for John Kerry and Barack Obama is certainly not very popular, nor is it very easy. I kind of think being a conservative from where I'm from in Palm Beach County is kind of like fighting behind enemy lines. And so the reason though that I brought up the story about Joe is that while I know so many of you know about Marco Rubio's story about being the son of Cuban exiles who came to America because they lost their country in a revolution, and they came here to America and were so fortunate to live the American dream. And Marco really captured the hearts and minds of the American people during the last election. Now, I can't tell you that I'm the son of immigrants, but what I can tell you is that I'm the son of two liberal Jewish Democrats.
You're kidding.
Who was born in Brooklyn, New York.
His father's not happy
with it. So it's kind of like being from a different country. But the reason why I tell you that story and it connects back to Joe Green is this. Joe Green, as a black gentleman, looked at me and he said, when you talk about taking back this country, I want you to make sure that you're being inclusive. Mm-hmm. And I told Joe, I said, Joe, I'm Jewish. I understand what it's like to be a minority of a minority. I understand what it's like to go against the grain, even when it's not popular in your own community and in spite of your family influences, to stand up for things that are just things that you believe in your core. And Joe Green, it was 7 o'clock in the morning. He was just getting off of work. I noticed that he didn't have the tie on that he had on the night before. And Joe Green unbuttoned his button and he showed me that he was wearing a Star of David.
Wow. All right.
Talk about inspiration for the campaign.
That's goosebumps.
This morning, I'm ready to fight. That's what we need in Washington, D.C. right now. We need people up there who have the courage to say what needs to be said and do what needs to be done, even when it's not popular. And I did that in the Florida legislature. When every Republican was moving toward the Charlie Crist camp of the Republican Party, saying Republicans need to be more moderate, Republicans need to tone down their message, that after 06 and 08, it was because we were too conservative, I was saying no. Republicans don't need to be less partisan. Republicans need to be more principled. And that's what we need in Washington, D.C. People to go up there and join with the Jim DeMint and the Mike Lees and the others who are ready to fight, because we recognize that this is that time when we need to challenge the status quo on both sides of the political aisle and help to save this country.
Yes.
And I'll conclude with this. In 1980, when Ronald Reagan ran for president, he asked the American people one very simple question. He said, are you better off today than you were 4 years ago? Well, the question that I think we need to be asking today is, where do we want America to be 5 years from now? I have a much different vision for this country than the path we are currently on. I believe we can rise to the generational challenge like prior generations did at so many other critical moments in our nation's history. I believe we can cut spending, that we can balance the budget, that we can reform our entitlement system, that we can get government out of the way, and so that we can inspire economic prosperity. I believe that we can restore a peace through strength national security policy, where our enemies know that we oppose them, and our allies know that we stand with them. And I know that we can recapture those foundational Judeo-Christian principles, those moral values that have led to the deterioration, as we push God out of the conversation, as we continue in this climate of political correctness. I know we can restore that. I know we can find that same can-do American spirit, that belief that America is safer when America is stronger, and that moral clarity. But it's going to take hard work, and it's going to take sending the right people to Washington, D.C. And for all the hard work we did in 2010 to send Marco Rubio to the United States Senate, every vote that he takes is canceled out by Bill Nelson. And while some in this state believe that Bill Nelson was a blue dog moderate Democrat, he's been the biggest cheerleader for the Obama administration agenda. On stimulus, on Obamacare, on cap and trade, card check, all of the job-killing policies that are piling on debt on future generations and making us less safe and less secure. This election is about a choice. We need to send leaders to Washington who have the courage to say what needs to be said and do what needs to be done, even when it's not popular. It's not just about sending any Republican to Washington. It's about sending someone up there who has proven that they are going to stand up to Democrats and to Republicans who act like them. And so I know that this election and this campaign is not going to be easy. And as was already pointed out, there are other Republicans running. And I would tell you this, that I know we're going to be outraised and outspent, but I believe that money is not the only important thing in this election. We need leaders who have the conviction to go up and challenge what's taking place in Washington and not kick the can down the street once again. This is that time. I'm asking for your support. I'm here today to meet you, to answer your questions, to ask you to be a part of our movement. You can go to adamhasner.com. We have some brochures. You can follow us on Facebook, follow us on Twitter, and be a part of our team, be a part of our conversation, because now is that time. And I'm hoping that you will join me to fight Washington and save the United States of America. Thank you all so much, and good morning.